New warnings tonight about a highly touted weed killer that's now banned.
8 months after the EPA stopped the sale of Imprelis, it appears the damage may be larger than first thought. And as 12 News Colleen Henry reports, many still may not know last year's lawn treatment may be killing their trees.
It looks nice. No weeds. It's got good color.
Great grass is Shane Leonard's business. So when DuPont touted a super effective, environmentally friendly new herbicide last year, Leonard used it on his 400-plus Royal Lawn customers. Within 4 weeks, his customers' trees started dying.
I was devastated. I was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to lose my business. You know, everybody's going to be blaming me.
Leonard wasn't alone. Landscapers across the country were seeing the same damage.
Usually a new growth is green. That's dead.
Browning tips, curling limbs, eventual death. DuPont says most damage is concentrated across the nation's midsection from Minnesota and Wisconsin as far east as New Jersey. Norway spruce and white pine are the hardest hit.
It turns the grass green.
Leonard immediately told his clients about the problems with Imprelis, and 24 joined him in suing DuPont. But Leonard says a number of lawn companies haven't warned their customers to look for tree damage or to avoid planting other trees in treated areas.
Homeowners have no idea that that was an affected tree by Imprelis. They have no idea that they shouldn't be planting a new tree. Just they thought the tree died, and so they took it out and put it in a new one.
And the bad news keeps coming. Leonard says what first seemed to be a problem with evergreens is now showing up in hardwoods.
There it is.
Dan Henderson says the leaves fell off his maple last summer. He didn't realize it was dying.
Come spring and there's nothing on it. And I plant that tree almost about that big.
Henderson says DuPont hasn't answered most of his questions.
Can I plant a tree back in the same spot? Is it going to affect it? They won't tell us. They won't give us any information. And you figure they should.
DuPont did not return 12 News call for comment, but according to its website, the company set up a claim system that requires tree owners to agree not to sue. With the extent of damage still growing, Leonard and his customers say they'll let the courts decide. In Brookfield, Colleen Henry, WISN 12 News.
For a link to DuPont's Imprelis information page, go to WISN.com.